to join me on Thursday, 7 p.m., but now is the time. You're listening to Now is the Time. Tune in.
Go.
You're listening to Now is the Time. You stay there. I'll be here. Be right back.
This is Deep End Media.
www.deependmedia.net.
God bless you out there. This is Paul Dunn. I'm your host for this evening. For Now is the Time. I pray that whatever you're doing on today, that it's been a good day for you. I tell you, we thank and praise God for all that's going on. I am so excited to be back in the DFW area. I want to send out my condolences to Kid Craddock and his family from 106.1 in the DFW area. There was a appreciation for Kid, which is actually going on right at this moment at the AA Center American Airline Plaza. And there was hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people there, and I was just so thankful to be able to get an opportunity to be there and just to be a blessing. Kid has been an awesome individual and, of course, had a syndicated radio show all across America. And so, once again, we want to just thank God for the gift that he had placed within Kid and all he's done, Kid's kids, that we're going to continue to support as he was reaching out to kids throughout America to be a blessing to them. I want to, first of all, talk about my sponsors, and I'm going to be so thankful for what they're doing. Jay's Barbershop, which is located at 405 North McDonald Street in McKinney, Texas, 75069. You can give him a call at 469-288-8898. Once again, that's 469-288-8898. Jay, if you're out there and you're listening, give me a call at 214-504-3854. You can give me a call probably about 7:30 or so. It'll be good. I'll get a chance to chat with you just for a moment. Also, Covenant Credit. We give you credit for who you are. They're located also at 405 North McDonald Street, Suite C, McKinney, Texas, 75069. Their phone number is 972-529-6888. And be sure to tell them that Now is the Time recommended you. You can also go to their website if you like, and that's at mymoneytogo.com. That's www.mymoneytogo.com. We're so excited. We've got an airing that we're going to show you on tonight. The program is called It's a Mind Thing. It's something that I taped with Terrence and Tarsha Johnson from Higher Dimension in Houston, Texas. They interviewed me on TBN, carried live around the world. And we're going to be showing that on tonight. It's a Mind Thing. It's actually available on DVD. It's going to be officially released in September, but you're going to get a chance to see it on tonight. I'll be there being interviewed by Terrence and Tarsha. Also, we have a special guest, Melody Rocks, who's on our record label, Captown Records International. Also, we have a clip there that you can see from the National Child Identification Program that we're a part of, that's sponsored by the Federal Bureau of Investigations, the American Football Coaches Association that represents all 32 NFL ball teams, as well as the Walmart Foundation. Once again, I'm putting it out there again. If the kids that are out there and you're listening to on tonight and you're in the DFW area, because we have listeners from LA to New York, Canada, Mexico, Germany to Japan, we're sponsoring kids to get their haircut going back to school. Now, I understand here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area that the kids are going to be going back to school another week or so. And we start at 25 and we're down to, I think, about 5 slots left. And so if you're out there and you'd like to have your kids' hair cut, we're sponsoring that. We'll pay for that. We'll hook you up. You can go over to Jay's Barbershop and get it done on a Sunday, which will be the day before school starts back. Outside of that, Jay's does $7 Sundays for kids. And so if you're out there and you just want to take your kid and get a haircut, you can take him to Jay's on Sundays, and it's $7. Once again, Jay is located at 405 North McDonald Street. You can reach him at 469-288-8898. 8898. You need no appointment. Walk-ins are welcome. And I think he'd be a real blessing. He's my personal barber. I call him the executive barber. But tonight, we're going to be coming back after this program of that you're going to take a look at. It's a mind thing, and we're going to continue to move forward. We're going to be talking about strongholds on tonight and how you can get free of those strongholds. I'm so excited about upcoming guests. Mr. Ray Huffines is going to be here with us in the next couple of weeks. He is the owner of Ray Huffines Auto Dealerships here in Texas. They have about 8 dealerships throughout the area. I'm so excited to have a relationship with him, and he's been such a blessing to us, and I want to thank and praise God for him. Also, Kobe Randolph is going to be joining us. He wrote the book, The Champagne Life. Now, you're going to really enjoy this young man. He's an awesome, awesome gentleman. He's in Los Angeles, California, doing a lot of things, a real moving shaker, and we're so thankful for him. And also, Dr. Bruce Randolph, he's also going to be joining us. He's out of Memphis, Tennessee. So we've got some really good guests lined up that's going to come and really be a blessing to you. Also, don't forget, on September the 8th, we're launching the Champion Center, and that's going to be located in McKinney, Texas at Adriatica, and we're challenging you and inviting you to come out on Sunday, September 8th. It's going to take place from 12 noon to 1 p.m. Then we're going to have some snacks and some refreshments, and then we're going to be doing some networking. And so bring your business cards. That's what it's about. We want to connect you with the right people. You can't be an eagle and hang out with turkeys. We're looking for people who are serious about what they're doing, who can come and bring us a professional proposal, and we have some what I call investment sharks that are willing to invest the money to start up capital to get you started. Of course, there's a percentage tied into that, and so we'll talk more about that. You can also visit our website at www.genesisgroup1.com, and you get a lot of information on what we have going on in reference to our record label, our clothing line, our stage play, my speaking engagements. There's just so much there that I think will be a major blessing to you. Listen, I want to download. I want to teach you how to do what I do. And that's how I'm doing the things I'm doing today. I had mentors that took me under their wings for 3 years. Alan Hattie Hollingsworth, and they run and own Avalon Corporation out of Diamond Bar, California. They're probably doing about $60 million a year, and I'm just so thankful they took me under their wing and flew me back and forth to California for 3 years. And I don't have a formal education. I have a sixth grade dropout from the hovels of poverty. Go to the ghetto, single parent home on welfare. But I want you to know that God will take the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. And I'm going to challenge you on today. To trust the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding, but acknowledge him in all your ways, and he shall and he will direct your path. Matthew 6:33 says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things, all this stuff that you need will be added unto you physically, financially, emotionally, spiritually, and socially. Listen, now is the time for change. Listen, we're going to take a break. And we're going to come back with the It's a Mind thing. And I know this is going to be a real blessing to you. Once again, this is Paul Dunn with Now Is the Time. And we are so excited. I tell you, I am on tiptoe anticipation about what's happening. I want you to know something. Don't complain about that which you allow. Many people like to complain. You have to understand that death and life are in the power of your tongue. The Bible says that as a man thinketh, so is he. And so you have to begin to think about what you're going to say before you say it. I want to help you change your paradigm. A paradigm is how you view the world around you. I want to teach you discipline, how to delay your gratification, balance, how to let the lesser things die, the greater may live, how to bind to procrastination. Procrastination is waiting on a perfect time or condition. Listen, if you wait for everything to be just right in your life, if you wait to get the right car, the right house, the right amount of money in the bank, if you wait till everything is just right, you will never do anything. Then we're going to talk about now, how you can operate in your now. Your now is defined as 2 to 5 seconds when God downloads a dream or a vision or an idea before it passes into your past memory files. And then there's a principle that I teach called the repo principle. The R is repetitious, the E is easy, the P is pleasure, the O is often, and the H is habit. Whatever you do repetitiously will become easy. Whatever becomes easy will become a pleasure. Whatever becomes a pleasure, you'll do often. And whatever you do often will become a habit. Your whole life is built on memories and habits. You are a creature of habit. Listen, we got a lot in store for you on today. And once again, I want to thank all those out there that support us. Of course, the Young Millionaires Association, PBJ Clothing. We're just so thankful. We're getting more sponsors now than we really wanted. But it just goes to show you how God says, I will do exceedingly and abundantly above all you may think, ask, or imagine. I'm going to open in prayer. And then we're going to continue to move forward in the program. Father, we thank you on today for all you've done and all you're going to do. Lord, those that are out there listening now, I pray that you'd anoint their ears, they may hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Lord God, they will begin to realize and recognize, Lord God, that the relationship they have with you is the greatest relationship of all time. Lord, that their life can be changed in a moment. Lord, I pray for all those that are challenged today, whether they're sick, Lord God, whether they're challenged, whether it's physically or financially, emotionally, spiritually, or socially. My prayer today, Lord, is that I would decrease, that you may increase. Not my will, Lord God, but that thine will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now we look to the hills from which cometh our help, for our help cometh from the Lord. For every good and perfect gift comes from above, from the Father of lights, and there is no variance. Father, I thank you that greater is he that's in us than the evil that's in the world. If God be for us, who can be against us? Nay, in all the things we are facing, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. The Bible says, without faith, it's impossible to please God. Faith is a substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. As it is written, the just shall live by faith. Now we look to the hills from which cometh our help, for our help cometh from the Lord. Father, I ask that you use me today as a vessel, Lord God. I pray now, Lord God, that I will become nothing and that you may become everything. And before we ask you for anything, Lord, we want to thank you for everything. Everything you've already done, Lord God. We thank you for another day. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will and we shall rejoice and be glad in. Father, we thank you now. We give you praise, glory, and honor. In your Son, Jesus' name, I pray. Amen, amen. Listen, we're going to go to break. You stay there. I'll be here. We'll be right back.
It's not comfortable. It doesn't feel good. But we need to just take solace in the fact that even though it may not feel good right now, as long as I'm in his hands, I know that everything is going to be all right. Just text somebody, look him in the face, and tell him I'm in his hands.
He sees the tears you cry,
and he shares
your pain inside.
And sometimes
you wonder why he allows you to go through what you go through.
Of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Truly, when you've been transformed in your mind, you won't be ashamed to tell everybody about the goodness of Jesus Christ. Amen, amen. Thank God for Sandy for blessing our heart with that. We have another guest here. Amen. The Lord is doing some marvelous things in his life. Pastor Paul Don, amen, an entrepreneur, business person, dreamer, visionary, just all of that. And he's in the house today, and he's going to come and bless us, amen. Let's give him a hand, amen. Pastor Paul Don, amen. Bless you, man. Good to have you. And you looking nice and all that.
Thank you, sir. I always say it's good to be anywhere.
Right. What's going on, man? Just your resume is just so awesome. What the Lord is doing in your life, and every chance I get to bump into some individuals that are being used by the Lord. Truly, I want to hear their testimony.
Amen.
What the Lord is doing. So what's going on?
Well, one thing I want to say about Pastor DeCesare is he was talking about being transformed. And I believe that it all starts in the mind.
Sure.
And I often say it's a mind thing. The Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. And so the first thing that happened, that had to happen in my life, I had to change my mind, change the way I think.
Yeah.
I had to get a paradigm shift on how I view the world around me.
Right.
And once I got a perception of who Jesus Christ was in my life, it changed my life. Because what you put in is what's going to come out.
Yeah.
And as God began to give me dreams and visions and ideas, he showed me the only way he can give birth to things in the planet, he's got to bring them through somebody.
Mm.
And so I had to get to a point where I stopped praying for God just to meet my immediate needs. The Bible says that we're blessed in order to be a blessing, but it's hard to bless someone else when you're concerned about how you're going to pay your phone bill.
Sure.
Or how you're going to make your ends meet for this week. And so God is a big God. And so he's stretching us now, and he's calling us into a new thing. And I always tell people, if God is doing a new thing, we can't keep doing the same old thing.
Sure.
Our God loves you. There's nothing he won't do for you. He said, there's no good thing I would withhold from those that walk upright before me. So I believe that when you get in the zone with God, the Bible promises that whatever you put your hands to, he will cause it to prosper. And wherever the soles of your feet, your tread upon, that have I given unto you. Mm-hmm. So many times we need to change our minds so we can change what we talk. Sure. See, people don't talk, Pastor, about things they don't believe. Mm-hmm. So they don't think they could ever be in a different situation or circumstance. They won't talk about it.
So just speak it.
You got to begin to speak it. The Bible says we can call those things as not as though they were. Mm-hmm. Here I am with a sixth grade education from the hovels of poverty, gutter of the ghetto, single parent home on welfare from North Tulsa. And in my environment, people said I would be nothing. Mm-hmm. But I told my mom when I was a baby, I said, Mom, I'm going to buy you a house in Beverly Hills. And even my own mother didn't believe me. And she fell on the floor and she laughed and laughed. And finally, when she caught her breath, she said, boy, you are quite the dreamer. And she was right, because I had to see it on the inside before it could manifest on the outside. And many times we're dictated to by outside forces, other people. I call it cathexing, people casting their personality and vision on another person, object, or thing. They can't do it, so you can't do it. Why let us sit here and die when we don't have to? Mm. I never forget praying from the Oral Roberts hands in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And I looked around at Oral Roberts University, and some of the viewers out there may have seen, been to the campus. And I said, God, look at this. One man, you've given birth to a whole university, a business center. And God said to me, get up, my son. I can't do no more through you than you believe me for. Mm. And at that point right there, I had a paradigm shift. I had been praying to God for $50 and $100 and then $200. And I got up, Pastor, and I went back to my prayer closet, and I asked God, I said, God, I need $10 million. Mm. Now, a lot of you out there are intimidated with even saying million. But our God is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you may think, ask, or imagine. We've got too many small-minded, too many petty folks in the kingdom. Mm-hmm. Our God is well able. I know that the world is saying that we're in a recession. But that's why it's so important we be not conformed to the world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, because there is no shortage in the kingdom. Sure. There is no recession in the kingdom. Our God is not about to file chapter 11, 12, or 13. Our business just exceeded 12%. Yeah. So we don't know anything about a recession, because the God we serve is still on the throne. And so now's the time for the kingdom of God to begin to come forth. I believe that there's been an entrepreneurial spirit released upon the kingdom of God. People out there watching today feel like you're too tall, you're too short, you're too fat, you're too black, you're too white. It's too late. But I come by to tell you, you can dream again.
Yeah.
Because God now is downloading dreams and visions and ideas.
He's
in this time
dreams.
That we give birth.
Yeah.
Many people are pregnant way past due. Pregnancy, normally, conception is the fun part. Then it's the carrying of the baby. And then there's the birthing table, the labor pains. The Bible says your weeping may endure for a night, but your joy will come in the morning. Many of you out there are pregnant, but it's the devil who come but to steal, kill, and destroy. He wants you to miscarry or to abort that thing that God has called you to do.
Yeah.
And it's not so important that you give birth just for you, because it's not about you. It's bigger than you. Mm-hmm. God wants to do something that's not going to just bless you, but it'll bless the folks around you. It'll bless the next generation. Because whatever God has given you, you can only carry it to a certain place. Mm-hmm. And then we delegate, we release that to the next generation or those folks coming up behind us, so they can go on to another level with God that we didn't go on. So I'm talking to my folks, and I'm sharing with them what God has put in me. You know, we got a lot of dream killers.
Yeah.
We got a lot of folks that are full of doubt and fear and unbelief, and they try to get you to think like they do. But once you've been transformed, I tell people, ain't a devil in hell that can stop you.
Yeah.
He says, up on this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not and cannot and will not prevail against it. Against all odds in my community, I begin to speak about this clothing line that God had given me. My CPA, my accountant, my attorneys, everyone said, there's enough clothing lines in the world. We don't need that. But when God gives you something, when God impregnates you, you don't listen to outside forces. I carried that dream all the way to Las Vegas, and on August 26th of 1990, I gave birth to a clothing line. Now, we don't sell t-shirts and caps. We have everything from t-shirts, caps, to leathers, to minks. I tell people this way, everything Tommy Hilfiger got, we got.
Yeah,
God will use anybody that will allow themselves to be used. So my testimony is God is well able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all you may think, ask, or imagine. Quit feeling sorry for yourself. Quit looking for somebody to pat you in the back. Like the man in the pool of Bethesda, he laid there 38 years.
Yeah.
Every time there was a stirring of the water, he said, there's no one to help me.
Yeah.
Well, what are you doing to help yourself?
Yeah.
We've got people praying to God for a new car and won't take care of the old one. They're praying to God for a bigger house and won't clean the small one. God says, you got to be faithful where you at. If you're faithful with a few things, I'll raise you up and make you rule over much. And so the message is change your mind. Pastor Decessor, that's what this is all about. Because until you change your mind, you cannot change your life. Mm-hmm. And change is not change unless you change.
Wonderful. Yeah, that's a blessing, man. That's awesome.
So I'm thankful that God has given me an opportunity, because sometimes people think you can't be successful unless you have a certain degree. Now, hear me. I am an avid supporter of education. Mm-hmm. But I know a whole bunch of educated derelicts. Mm-hmm. Just because you have a degree, that doesn't validate success.
Sure.
So my thing is to tap into the dreams and the visions and the ideas that God has impregnated you with so that you can go to the place where God wants you to go, because most of us, our job would never provide for you to do what God has called you to do. I don't care if you make $100,000, it's not going to be enough. God is bigger than that. So how do we get this into manifestation? The first thing we need is discipline. Discipline is delaying one's gratification. The second thing is balance. You have to let the lesser things die that the greater may live. We've got to bind up a spirit of procrastination. I see the spirit of procrastination just prevalent in the kingdom, waiting on a perfect time or condition to do what God has called you to do. The next spirit is a spirit of insanity, of doing the same thing over and over and over. Now, I ask you after watching, how many insane procrastinators do you know? And whatever you're going to do for God, you got to do now, because now is all you got. And now is defined as 2 to 5 seconds when God downloads a dream, vision, or an idea before it passes into your past memory files. God is doing a new thing. And if God is doing a new thing, we can't keep doing the same old thing.
That's awesome, Dan.
When do we change? Next year? Next month? You know, with this wintertime, people say it's too cold.
Yeah.
And then the springtime comes, it's too wet. The summertime comes, it's too hot. But when are we going to change? Is there any perfect time to change?
Yeah.
You've got to know your seasons in God. Winter is a time to plant. You won't find a farmer nowhere in the world planting during the winter.
Yeah.
It's a time to plant. Spring is a time to plant, to water, to take care of. Summer is a time to cultivate. And then autumn or fall is a time to reap the harvest. But if you don't plan nothing, you won't plant nothing. If you don't plant nothing, you won't water nothing. If you don't water, there'll be no harvest for you this year, just like it was last year. It's not God's fault. It's not the devil's fault. It's your fault. Because you've got to take the responsibility for the ability God placed in you. People who are unconscious are always trying to find somebody to blame. It's mama's fault. It's daddy's fault. It's the black man's fault. It's the white man's fault. No, it's your fault. The Bible says you shall know the truth, and it's the truth about you that's going to set you free. Now be free.
That's awesome, Doug. That's awesome.
But the church likes to be patted on the back and say everything's going to be all right. The best is yet to come. You know, God, Jesus going to work it out. They holding on to the horns of the altar. Man, my grandmother held on to the horns of the altar. Her mother held on to the horns of the altar. When are we going to get a manifestation? This generation needs to see a manifestation of the presence and the power of God.
Quit procrastinating.
Quit talking about what God. Let's see something. I've got drug dealers that I've ministered to, pimps and carjackers and ballers. They don't want to hear how good God is. They want to see the manifestation of his presence and his power. They want to see his hand move. That's what brings people to Christ. They've watched their grandmothers and their mother's mother and their fathers live life, one foot in the church and one in the world. They need to see a manifestation. They need to know that Jesus is real. A young man in Oakland told me, he said, I got to get paid. I said, I'm going to show you how to get paid and serve God. Ain't nothing wrong with having money in the kingdom, sure, as long as money don't have you.
Right.
You got to be economically empowered. You can't do what God has called you to do if you don't have some form of economics. Check, credit card, or some cash. You do nothing. But sit around and wait and pray. We've prayed long enough. When are we going to take an action? Faith without works is dead.
Amen. What a word. What a word. Pastor, what inspired you? What inspired you to say, hey, I'm going to quit procrastinating? You know, I'm going to quit talking about it. Hey, I'm going to be disciplined. I mean, how can we get up?
I got sick and tired of being sick and tired.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you know, sometimes you just get to the point, I got to the bottom of the barrel, and I said, I'm not taking this. There's got to be another way. I'm spending quality time with God. We talked about how to be transformed. God says, if you want what I got, give me what I want, and what I want is your attention. And when you spend quality time with God, you bond with God, and through bonding comes trust. He says, my children know my voice, and a stranger they would not follow. But you cannot get to know somebody you don't spend time with.
Sure.
And that's the problem in the kingdom, is we got time for everything else, but when it comes time for God, I'm too busy, I'm too tired, I'm too this, I'm too that. But the Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things that you have need of shall be added unto you, physically, financially, emotionally, spiritually. You got to get your priorities straight.
Yeah.
Seek ye first my way of doing things, and all the other stuff you need, I'll give you.
That's
a matter of priorities and a matter of looking yourself in the mirror and quit making excuses, quit procrastinating, quit operating insanity. The Bible says he has not given you a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. You don't have to be crazy no more. Be free. Go forth. Do what God has called you to do. It ain't a devil in hell that can stop you. Up on this rock, I'm going to build my church, and the gates of hell shall not and cannot prevail against anyone to step forth. Says Simon Bar-Jonah, talking to you now, I give unto you the keys to the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever you bind on this earth will be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you loose on this earth will be loose in heaven. You've got the power and the authority to bind and loose. I bound up poverty and I loose prosperity.
Amen.
Amen.
That's Amen. Awesome.
It's our time now. And if we don't do it now, when? Because now is all I got.
Because God said he wants us to have life.
Now. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for. Mm.
And have life more abundant.
More abundant. Jesus came that we might have life and have it that much more abundant. So if we're not experiencing the abundant life, whether it's physically, financially, emotionally, spiritually, or socially, it's not God's fault.
Taking advantage of the system that he's already provided.
He's already given us all things pertaining to life. Mm. Why stand you here gazing up the same way I left, the same way I'm coming back?
And we still gazing.
Still standing and waiting. He says, be about my father's business. When? Now. When? Now. Mm. That's what changed me. It changed because I got tired. And you quoted earlier, the Bible said, let the same mind which was in Christ Jesus be in you also. Let the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead live in you. When you get the mind of Christ, the spirit of God, I come by to tell you, it ain't a devil in hell that can stop you. Mm. It's a man thing.
That's an awesome word.
You got to get mad. The Bible says the kingdom of God stuff is body. The body take it up. I got mad.
Yeah. So they just got
to
get mad.
I got mad when I go to an ATM machine, put my card in and worry if I can get $5. I write a check and trembling and hoping it goes through. I got sick and tired, man. Every time I go to the store, I'm hoping my credit card ain't maxed out. Yet my father owns the cattle on a thousand, all the silver and all the gold. And I'm joining with Jesus, the kingdom. I'm walking on here trembling. Mm. Something wrong with that picture. Either God is who he say he is, or the biggest lie I've ever lived. Now, who do you say it is?
Well, he can't lie.
So either God's right, we wrong, or we right and God wrong. If I had to take sides, I'd say you messed up and you're wrong.
That's wonderful. That's
what they call a no-brainer.
That's truly wonderful. Well, Pastor Don, we want to know for the new year, do you have anything coming up? I see here you have a book.
Mm-hmm. I have a book that's out now called How to Stay Saved, Be Transformed, Renew Your Mind. Also in April, we have a new book coming out that I'm doing for Christian singles, and it's called How to Make Love and Keep Your Clothes On.
Wonderful. That's interesting.
It's promising to be a bestseller.
Yeah. Wow.
And I'm just excited because it is our time to take a stand, not only about physically and emotionally, spiritually, sure, and socially, but also take a stand in reference to our sanctification,
yeah,
and our holiness,
I like
and
that,
our righteousness in God. Man, make if you get in right standing with God, I'm telling you, it ain't nothing that's going to stop you. Mm-hmm. Most folks got so many other bottlenecks and areas of constraint that they don't know how to be a statistical process control. They don't know how to be a total quality manager. And that's what we're dealing with. People have to learn how to get their areas of constraint open. Some people have never experienced the love and the peace and the joy of God. Design and redesign means you got to make some changes, but people don't like change. They say, we've been doing this way for 15 years, and for 15 years it's not been working. Mm. And that's what procrastination does to you. It makes you say, well, we'll wait till the kids graduate from school. We'll wait till we get a new car. We'll wait for this. We'll wait for that. You've been waiting 15, 20 years. Folks are waiting for their ship to come in. I come by telling them, you keep doing what you're doing, you're going to keep getting what you got. If you want something different, you're going to have to do something different. It ain't going to never change.
Because God want to do a new thing in you.
In you.
Yeah.
Not Pastor, corporately, individually.
Pastor, definitely the anointing of God is on you, and the favor of God, amen, is on you. I'm glad you understand that, hey, faith without works is dead. Because a lot of folk think, hey, you just get, you know, $1 million.
Fast long enough.
Fast long
treat
enough.
Treat God like a genie in a bottle.
You know.
If you rub him long enough, he'll eventually pop out and say, your wish is my every command.
But what an awesome expression that you've embodied the word of God. And Pastor, I pray and hope those individuals who are listening, watching, that you apply this to your life. For truly, Pastor Don is a living example, amen, of what a life means in Christ. Amen. The sky's the limit. Amen. God can take you to a higher dimension. He can take you to the next level in every area of your life. Yes. You just got to believe it. You got to quit procrastinating. You got to learn to be disciplined. That's you got to
quit. Things you must do.
Yeah, you got to quit being insane, doing the same old things over and over. God said, I've come that you may have life and have life more abundantly. Our Father is rich. Yeah. The word of God declares the earth, yeah, belongs to the Lord, the fullness thereof, and the world that dwell therein. Listen, there are some folk who've been blessed
by Pastor Don. Listen, you need to call in. We have some prayer warriors who are waiting for you to touch and agree with you. You need to call in. We want to pray a prayer of deliverance from procrastination, from insanity. Yeah. Hey, there are some entrepreneurs in the body of Christ. Yes, God have divested a lot of gifts, a lot of talents, and we shouldn't have to go to the world. Whatever we need is in the body of Christ. And so we want you to call in right now. Hey, we're going to drop some baggage. Amen. We're going into the new year freed up, delivered, and set free. Pastor, you've set some folk free today.
Well, you know, I believe, Pastor, that you shoot for the moon. At least if you miss, you'll be among the stars.
Yeah.
Man, you know, man, go for it, man. Go after it. Uh-huh. You don't have anything to lose. And sometimes we've got to get away from a lot of those folks that we're hanging around with. You become a product of the environment. A lot of us just hanging out with the wrong folks. You cannot be an eagle and hang out with turkeys.
And the word of God said, blessed is the man that walk in, not in the counsel of the ungodly.
You know, one thing I want to do is we're going to pray, and I want people to know out there, if you like one of my books, I'd like to just bless them with it.
Okay.
And
is magically encoded in cutting-edge entertainment. Not a sweet 210.
What is it about the chicks that don't get the actual phasing? You know what I'm saying? If you're going to get the T-Bars look, get the damn T-Bars look.
Right.
Don't get the / T-Bars Sonic look. You know what I'm saying? You look like T-Bars in the front and the sides. In the back, you look like Sonic the damn Hedgehog. All this standing up like somebody shocked the hell out of you or something.
We've got an aging superstar as the reality, and then nobody else. And we didn't make the playoffs last year, by the way. Boy, that's a great selling point. What else you got? Well, you can hang out at the W. I think Lamar Odom's room still has some leftovers in there.
We like to go off the deep end when we deliver cutting-edge entertainment. So tell a friend to log on to the hottest station that's giving you cutting-edge entertainment.
Broadcasting in crystal clear digital.
DeepEndMedia.net.
We want to thank you
for spending your radio money with us.
If we don't deliver you cutting-edge entertainment, then the next hour is free of charge.
This is Deep End Radio. DeepEndMedia.net.
Hey, what's the most important thing you need when planning a party? The food! Don't party hungry. Call Deshawn's Catering. We carry a wide range of comfort, party, and soulful dishes to upgrade your taste buds. And we fit within a variety of budgets. You can choose from sweet and spicy meatballs to Cajun pasta with sausage or chicken. Then satisfy your sweet tooth with peach cobbler or our strawberry seduction sensation. Delicious, elegant, and soulful cooking. Call Deshawn's Catering for any event. 817-681-5879. Again, 817-681-5879. Or visit our website, deshawnscatering.com. Mention Deep End Radio and save 20% off of your total contract balance.
Search Deshawn's Catering on Facebook at Deshawn's Celebrity Catering. Follow Deshawn's Catering on Twitter at Deshawn's Catering.
Hey, this is Dre with Honestly Speaking. Tune into my shows on Thursdays at 8:30. We're going to be talking about relationships from both a man's perspective and a woman's perspective. As far as the topics go, it's anybody's guess. And so tune in Thursdays, 8:30, right here on Deep End Media Networks.
There's some strong inspiration headed your way.
Get inspired by the Word of God. Check out Inspirational Moments with Tanisha.
This is Tanisha, your host of Inspirational Moments. Inspirational Moments is an inspirational show that is giving words of encouragement and motivation.
Tune in to this inspirational, spiritual, and powerful show.
Heard every Saturday at 2:30 Central. Only on Deep End Radio. Cutting Edge Entertainment.
DeepEndMedia.net.
to the Deep End Media Network, www.deependmedia.net.
Welcome back. This is Paul Dunn. I'm your host for Now's the Time. I pray that you enjoy it. It's a mind thing that's going to be available coming up in September. It'll be available on DVD. We actually have a TV program. We're going to be airing that. It'll be airing into 86 million households in 200 countries. You could be able to catch that on television. We'll give you the exact station, things of that nature, in the upcoming weeks. Once again, thank you so much for tuning in on today. We're going to go and we're going to check out a couple of our artists on Captown Records. And the first one I want you to sit back and enjoy is a young man, 17 years old, actually 18 now, out of New Orleans, Louisiana. His name is Greg Beck. He's going to be performing on The First Date, produced by Chubby Checker's nephew. And he's a protege of Usher. I'm sure that you'll enjoy this. I'll be right back.
On the first date, yep, on the first date. On the first date, yep, on the first date. On the first date, yep, on the first date. So if you feel the way I feel, why wait?
See, I was chilling when I caught you up in my eyes. I saw you walking and you didn't even realize. You had your head down, messing with your cell phone. That's when I said, don't worry, baby, cause I'm not home.
Why he got you waiting, baby girl?
And finish shopping for something pretty in your size. Now all this shopping got me working up an appetite. Let's find somewhere to eat so we can grab a quick bite. We eating burgers and you took a big bite. A girl that's not shy, just the ones that I like.
You got ketchup on your lips, they looking so soft.
Now let me take my napkin out and wipe it
off. Can I get a kiss on the first date? Can I get a kiss on the first date? Can I get a kiss on the first date? So if you feel the way I feel, why wait? Can I get a kiss on the first date? Can I get a kiss on the first date? Can I get a kiss on the first date? So if you feel the way I feel, why wait?
I got that feeling since we've been chilling. Waited, girl, all my life.
That's Greg Beck on The First Date. If you'd like to check that out a little more, you can visit www.captownrecordsint.com, and you can hear a clip of all the artists. And I don't want you just to go in and listen to the clip. I want you to purchase it. You can get an MP3. I think they're $9.99. Or you can purchase an individual track. They're 99 cents each. And if you want that to be mailed out to you, I think it's $12.95. But if you go on to www.captownrecordsint.com, you can check that out. I want to, we've got a caller coming in now. Call, are you there? Call, are you there?
Hey.
Hello?
Hey, this is Jay.
Hey, Jay, how you doing, my brother?
All right.
This is, we've got Jay on the line right now. Jay is a gentleman that owns Jay's Barbershop there at 405 North McDonald Street in McKinney, Texas. Once again, we had talked about his $7
hello?
Sunday. Yes, are you there, Jay?
Hello.
Okay, I can hear you. We talked about Jay's Sunday cuts for kids. They're $7, and we're actually sponsoring some kids here in the community for those who may want to get their hair cut.
Hey, if you could, do us a favor. You got to turn your radio down because you're getting back feet and you're kind of like...
Turn it down.
Yeah, turn it down for me.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, yeah, how's that?
Okay, that's great. So once again, Jay offers $7 Sundays cut for kids, and we're actually sponsoring some kids here in the community. We did it over in Fort Worth. We did it in Arlington, and all you have to do is call in. And if you call in at 214-504-3854, we're ready to get you set up with Jay there in McKinney. Jay, tell us a little bit about Jay's Barbershop. How long have you been located there in McKinney?
The shop has been originally there since 1996. And it was currently owned by a young lady by the name of Miss Shelly Faye. And I've been currently in ownership since 07. So Jay's has been in business since 07, and we're serving the community, man, all in McKinney. I mean, it's steady growing, and hey, the more the merrier.
What's your hours there, Jay?
Generally 9 to 6, 7 days a week.
Do you have appointments, or is it walk-in, or how does that work?
Appointments is fine. Walk-ins is fine. We'll take all walking.
And that number they can call is 469-288-8898. If you're out there and you're listening and you want an excellent cut, Jay is my personal barber. I call him an executive barber. He will hook you up from top to the bottom. And I know a lot of the kids out there preparing to go back to school, and I know that parents are in need of help, school supplies, haircuts, clothing, things of that nature. And Jay, that was something that you were sharing with me, the booklet that you had got when you were in Memphis, Tennessee. Tell us a little bit, just an overview about that book. I know a lot of the young people don't know a lot of the black people who have established things, you know, in our society that they have no idea about. And Jay is going to be making these books available. And I want you guys out there listening, I want you to be able to contact him and get that. Give us just a little bit of information about that booklet, Jay.
Actually, and I had the chance to. I'm glad you brought that up. Actually, I had the chance to go to Memphis, Tennessee, and got a chance to see the Lorraine Motel that where Dr. Martin Luther King had got shot and killed. So, and they had a book there, and there's a book that if you come to Jay's, get a cut, you're gonna get presented with a book that it's inspirational. All kids should have this book in their hand.
Hmm. Now, Jay,
it don't cost you anything.
Amen.
If you come to Jay's Barbershop, you're gonna get presented, and you have kids. I want to put this in all kids' hands.
Well, Jay, you know, that's something that certainly interests me is when we talk about the kids, you know, I like what Martin Lawrence would say. Marty Moore loves the kids. And I tell you, it's us as the adults who are sowing into these young kids' life. And we're the examples. We're the mentors. We're setting the standards. And I have a heart for kids generally. And I'm just so excited that you would take it upon yourself to bring this book back from Memphis, Tennessee, and actually pay for the printing and then willing to distribute it for free. And all we're saying to you out there listening audience is that you just need to go by Jay's Barbershop. And me and Jay talk about this all the time, how we offer so many different things, and people almost want you to come pick them up, don't you, Brother Jay, and bring them to the shop and get pay for the cut, and then probably take them to lunch and take them back home and tuck them in bed.
Yeah. We talked about it. It's you know, there's a key thing that, you know, we talk about. It's all about that opportunity and what you do with it, you know. And I was just looking at the show, and you said a key thing. It happens in seconds. It come across you in seconds.
Well, you know,
and when it does, you got to grab it.
Well, you know, sometimes when an opportunity presents itself, you know, it can really be in the moment. And I often say, you know, now it's defined as 2 to 5 seconds when you get a dream, vision, idea. It's like having a dream in the midnight hour and you don't, you know, retain it. And the next morning, you're trying to piece it back together. A lot of times that comes out of procrastination because people have developed habits of putting things off. It's just amazing to me how someone will put off something for a whole month, which is something they can do in 10 minutes. And, this spirit is prevalent, you know, and a lot of times in our community per se, it's almost like pulling teeth with no anesthetic. You know, I'm finding more people that are upset and mad at folks, and they're more concerned about getting drunk and getting high and stealing and robbing. Listen, there's no life in crime, and it's no need of you being upset with someone. You know, anger is like drinking poison and expecting the other person to die.
Exactly.
All it does
And I actually had got the book. I have a 10-year-old. I actually got the book from a 10-year-old. But then actually when I saw it, read it, you know, it educated me on some things I didn't know. And I just had to spread it. I want to spread it. You got to.
Well, Jay, I am so excited, man. You know, I love you, man, and I always have. You know, God, I feel like God really has connected us. And from the time, you know, the way I met Brother Jay was through the shop, and he actually, you know, you have a connection with someone when they invite you to their family reunion. And many times when people invite you to things, they don't really, in some cases, they don't anticipate you even showing up. But Jay invited me, and I showed up, and I tell you, it was just a match that I believe that God really allowed us to connect. And, you know, I had got into a challenge or an accident, and I was actually in the hospital in McKinney, Texas. And this is what really bonded me with Brother Jay. He literally got in his car and drove to the hospital and cut my hair in the hospital room. And, man, I just, you know, I want the whole world to know, man, we're on all over the world. And I want people to know, man, that's what relationships are. Relationships is about connecting with people, man. There's not two passing ships in the midnight hour. You know, I believe that you're a product of the environment. So if you hang out with the wrong people, you probably end up doing the wrong things. And so sometimes we just have to change our environment and change who we're hanging out with. And that's why we're launching the Champion Center coming up on September 8th. And I'm challenging and inviting people to come. Listen, it's only an hour. Some people say, well, how long is it going to be? Listen, man, it's like me telling you, I give you $100,000. All you have to do is get to Hawaii. You shouldn't make excuses. You should want to get more information. Information and knowledge is power. And that's one of the things I see, Jay, in our communities all across the country is when you think you know everything, it makes you ignorant because nobody knows everything.
Exactly.
And so I see the barbershop as a place, a wonderful opportunity. Every time I come in, I'm just excited to come. I go see Brother Jay. Every time I fly into Dallas, he's one of the people on my list I go and see. And Brother Jay, I just want you to know I love you, man. And I want those out there to call and or just go into Jay's barbershop. Once again, his phone number is 469-288-8898. He's located at 405 North McKinney or North McDonald Street in McKinney, Texas at 75069. Once again, he has $7 Sunday cuts for kids. I know that school is getting ready to start back up here in the Texas area, and I know there's people out there listening. Listen, all you have to do is pick up the phone. All you have to do is pick up the phone. You couldn't possibly be that lazy. Pick up the phone and dial 214-504-3854, and we'll get you set up, Brother Jay, and cut it for you. You know, Jay, this has been a challenge for me trying to help people, and it's like they don't want help even though they need help.
Yes, yes.
Do you have any suggestions of what we can do to maybe get a little more involved in the community?
Man, word of mouth is foul, man. So we doing the right thing. We just got to keep moving forward and doing what we do. You know, I was blessed to put my hands on people, man, and that's what I'm doing. I mean, so it wasn't a thing to come to the hospital and take care of my client. I mean, that's what I do. That's what he blessed me to do. So, hey.
Well, you never know, man.
We're going to push it. This is what we're going to do. We're going to get some attention.
Well, I tell you, man, I love it. Appreciate you. And I often tell people, push yourself, challenge yourself, never stop. And at the end of the day, ask yourself, what am I going to do next? There's always a next. And that's what I'm so excited about. Man, we have a lot of things going on. You know, I'm so excited. We've got Ray Huffines coming on the program. You know, and he's going to share his knowledge. He's a man that's a multi-millionaire. God's given me unmerited favor with him. He's going to be coming on the show, talking, giving out information. Now, listen, the people are perishing for the lack of knowledge. And you just can't hook up with someone like a Ray Huffines who owns 8 dealerships throughout the DFW area. You just can't walk in and hook up with Troy Aikman and so many other people that God has given me favor with that I want to present their information knowledge. I've often said, if I can do what you do, if I know what you know. And so thank you so much, Brother Jay, for calling in, man. We love you. We appreciate you. And I will continue to push and share what's going on there at Jay's Barbershop. If there's ever anything I can do to help you, all you have to do is call me.
All right. I appreciate it.
Okay. Love you, my brother. Thank you so much.
All right.
That was Brother Jay from Jay's Barbershop. Once again, he's located at 405 North McDonald Street in McKinney, Texas at 75069. You give him a phone call at 469-288-8898. Once again, he has Sunday $7 cuts for kids. Also, we're sponsoring some kids to go back to school. And I've got a surprise that I'm going to tie in with that, sponsoring the kids for the haircuts. But there's some other things I want to provide as well because I know you need more than just a haircut. And so all we're asking you to do is to call in so we know we're limited to how many people we can do. I can't get every kid's hair in Dallas cut, but I can commit myself to help one. I believe I can just change one person's life. If I can just reach one person, I believe my job is done. We're also tied in with Kroger's. If you shop at Kroger's in the DFW area, they have $7 kits. You can go there and you can just purchase a kit and they'll put it in the bin to help another kid. Listen, what you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. Our affiliated church, we're probably sponsoring about 1,000 kids there. We're providing their school supplies. We even provided some clothing, some shoes. I mean, these are things that make a difference. I believe this. People that in the church always want to say, I'll pray for you. But I believe it all happens after prayer. A person comes to you who don't have any shoes, who doesn't have a coat, who doesn't have a place to live. Prayer is not what they need. They need somebody to respond. They need someone to take action. And faith without works is dead. I want you to stay there. I'm going to be here. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back.
If I only could say one word, it would be grateful for all the things you've done. If I only could say one word, it would be grateful for all the things you've done. You live
Deshawn's Catering. We carry a wide range of comfort, party, and soulful dishes to upgrade your taste buds. And we fit within a variety of budgets. You can choose from sweet and spicy meatballs to Cajun pasta with sausage or chicken. Then satisfy your sweet tooth with peach cobbler or our strawberry seduction sensation. Delicious, elegant, and soulful cooking. Call Deshawn's Catering for any event. 817-681-5879. Again, 817-681-5879. Or visit our website, deshawnscatering.com. Mention Deep End Radio and save 20% off of your total contract balance.
Search Deshawn's Catering on Facebook at Deshawn's Celebrity Catering. Follow Deshawn's Catering on Twitter at Deshawn's Catering.
Hey, this is Drea with Honestly Speaking. Tune into my shows on Thursdays at 8:30. We're going to be talking about relationships from both a man's perspective and a woman's perspective. As far as the topics go, it's anybody's guess. So tune in Thursdays, 8:30, right here on Deep End Media Networks.
Get socially interactive.
Follow us on Twitter at Deep End Radio.
Music is only heard here first.
Radio.
So blown away, tornado.
Welcome back. This is Paul Dunn with Now's the Time. You are just listening to Melody Rock's Blown. I'm so thankful for what God is doing through the Captown Records CD introducing. You can check that out if you like and get a little more in depth with it if you just visit www.captownrecordsint.com. That's Captown, C-A-P-T-O-W-N, recordsint.com, and you can get more information about that. Shoot us an email at genesis@genesisgroup1.com. If there's anything we can do to assist you, we're looking for new artists right now for our next release. If you're out there and you're listening, that particular CD was recorded down in Houston, Texas, with Matthew Knowles there at Music World, and we're so excited for what God is doing through that CD all over the world. They've been selling like hotcakes, and I'm just so excited. We're moving into the Captown Records, introducing the newest CD that we're coming out for Christmas. Also, our Born in Hell, the stage play, the DVD, will be ready and released in September. If you go onto the website, you can pre-order it. You can get a little more information about it. We actually will be putting a show on here in Dallas. We're just working on some logistics right now, but you can certainly go to www.genesisgroup1.com and take a look at that. Also, you can follow me on Twitter. At DunDun58. That's DunDun58. If you're out there and you like Twitter, you can just shoot me a tweet at DunDun58, and I certainly will respond to you. Or you can email me at DunFiveEight@msn.com. And if you do that, I certainly will respond to you rather quickly. I stay on top of those things so that, you know, I always say it's better to keep up than to catch up. We talked a little bit earlier about strongholds. You know, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 10:4-5, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. That's in 2 Corinthians 10:4-5. Even though you may have been tormented, defeated, and cast down, if you will heed the message, God will light on you how to have victory in your present state and help you to win every battle in your life. Listen, there are thousands of people who are going through. What are you experiencing? Because as people, as individuals, Satan, devil, Beelzebub, whatever label you've given him, he come but to steal, kill, and destroy. Jesus says, I come that you might have life and have it that much more abundantly. What Satan wants to do is to defeat you. He wants to deceive you. He wants to vex you. He wants to keep you from the truth. For he knows that the truth will set you free. The Bible says that you shall know the truth, and it's the truth that shall set you free. They take a little care. Most people just take just a very little care in guarding their minds. They fill their minds with television programs, radio programs, newspaper articles, magazines, and conversations of the world. There are thousands of thoughts that enter into their minds, all concerning the things of the world. The Bible speaks of the weapons of our warfare. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. The area of our thoughts is a battlefield. The warfare starts in the mind. Then it spreads to the areas of our life. That's why I often tell people, in order to change your life, you got to change your mind. You are a creature of habit. Every action that you take is preceded by a thought. It's like getting up in the morning. You first have to, before you get out of the bed, you're, oh my God, I got to get up. I need to take a shower. I've got to leave. You know, all these are thoughts. And then you get out of the bed and you proceed to do those things that you were thinking about. Everything in your life starts with a thought. And so in order to change your life, you have to change your mind. And when you change your mind, you'll change your life. Listen, life is very challenging, period. We all have situations, circumstances that we deal with on a daily basis. I believe that you're in a storm, coming out of a storm, or you're headed into a storm. It's just called life. Nobody is exempt from that. I don't care about what your status is, your economical status, your geographical location, or what type of car you drive, what kind of clothes you wear. Listen, it's all about what you give yourself to. That which you give yourself to, that spirit will come to live in you. Now, we live in a society where people don't really recognize the spirits that are invading them. And usually it comes through a television, a radio, a newspaper, and people give themselves to that. There are people that will sit and watch television 12, 15, 16 hours a day. They watch the 10 o'clock news. I call it the bad news at 10. You know, and what happens is it begins to program you to make you think that life is just one big bad place. I want you to know that when you begin to change your thoughts, you'll begin to talk different. You'll begin to walk different. You'll begin to go to different places. Sometimes you have to leave some of the people that you're dealing with. I often say you can't be an eagle and hang out with turkeys. So many times you've got to change your environment. You have to change your friendships. You have to change the people that you're associating with, because a lot of people are not trying to go anywhere. I call them dream killers, visionary vampires. They'll do anything to stop you from fulfilling the purpose and the plans and the God has for your life. You were predestined. Even before you were formed in your mother's womb, God says, I knew you and called you and ordained you a prophet unto this nation. He wants to get the greatness out of your life. In your life, everybody listen to me right now, whether you're in L.A., New York, whether you're in Germany, Japan, whether you're in Mexico or Canada, everybody has some type of dream or vision, or everybody has a talent or a gift. And what God is trying to do is get that gift out of you. Not so much so it can be a blessing to you. The Bible says you're blessed or to be a blessing, but God knows if I can get this gift out of you, because what you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. It's just amazing. People, I meet kids who can just draw and paint like they've been to Juilliard. I meet people who just have natural talents and they've never studied and never been to school. It's like myself. I have a sixth grade education. I'm from the hovels of poverty, gutter of the ghetto, single parent home on welfare. But I've traveled the world. I've spoken to some of the top churches and organizations and seminars and conferences in America. And I thank and praise God for the gift. My gift is to coordinate, organize, and communicate. That's what I do. I don't play any instruments. I don't sing. I don't do any of that. I'm an entrepreneur. An entrepreneur is one who takes calculated risks for private profit. That's why it's so important that we discipline ourselves and delay our gratification. That's why it's so important that we get balanced in our life, that the lesser things die, that the greater may live. I want to see you tap into what we call serendipity and synchronicity. Serendipity is the gift of finding things not sought after, and synchronicity is the highly improbable events that happen with great frequency. When you get into the zone, the Bible says that whatever you put your hands to, God will cause to prosper. He says, wherever the soles of your feet should tread on, he says, that have I given unto you. He says, whatever you put your hands to, he will cause the problem. So we have to be conscious of what we touch. We have to be conscious of where we go. It amazes me how people can, every week, repetitiously, they go to the nightclub, and that's become easy. It's a pleasure. They do it often. That's a habit. They spend more time investing in trying to chase women and trying to drink and wanting to get high and playing games. Listen, life is too short. We're headed to the finish line. You can't go backwards. Every moment, every second that you invest is gone into eternity. It never returns. And so whatever we're going to do, we have to do now, because now's all you got. Your change is not going to come over the next 6 months, over the next year. Your change will happen in a moment of time. Bam, change. And that's what we're talking about. You can begin to live it, and now you're changed. Now you're delivered. Now you're set free. Listen, I was bound by crack cocaine for years. My mom passed when I was 17 years old. It was devastating to me, and I got tied into drugs. I was probably on drugs 3 or 4 years. I mean, totally ruined my life to where I was sleeping under a bridge in Miami, Florida. I used to live in a Shell gas station bathroom in San Francisco. And finally, I got sick and tired of being sick and tired. I said, I know there's got to be more to life than me trying to see how much money I can get today so I can go buy another hit of crack, see how much money I can get just so I can go get something else to drink. Listen, it was a cycle, and I had done it so long. It was repetitious. It became easy. It became a pleasure. I done it often, and it became a habit. Listen, it takes time to change a habit. Our statistics show us, and psychologists and psychiatrists says, it normally takes 30 days to change a habit. We have a program, Purpose, Plan, Destiny. It's a 90-day training program, and what it does, it teaches you how to give birth to the dreams, the visions, and the ideas that you have on the inside of you. Maybe you want to write a book. Maybe you want to start a business. Maybe you need to expand what you're doing. Maybe you need more income. Listen, I want to show you how you can take a little bit of nothing and make a whole lot of something. If you're faithful over a few things, then you can be ruled over much. But if you're not faithful with $10, then what's going to happen if you get $1,000? If you're not faithful with $100, what's going to happen if you get $10,000? You see, it's the same thing. It's just more numbers. And so you've got to get faithful right where you are right now. You can't wait for a perfect condition. You know, it ties you to procrastination. You can't wait till you get everything together. You can't wait till you get the right house, the right car, the right job. Listen, whatever you're going to do, you have to do now. Start with what you got. In this program, I show people how you can take $100 and turn $100 into $5, $5 into $1,000, $1,000 into $2,500, $2,500 to $5,000, and $5,000 to $10,000. Listen, it's not many people out there listening today who can't come up with $100. And so I'm challenging you to come out and to connect with us. It's all about being a product of the environment. As I shared earlier, my mentors who mentored me for 3 years invested their time and their energy and their wisdom and their knowledge. And listen, I wasn't sitting up under them playing games. I didn't want him to be my source. I didn't want him to give me a fish. I said to my mentor, teach me how to fish. Then I can fish when I want, as long as I want, as often as I want. And that's what I'm endeavoring to do now, is to teach and to download the same information that I have to others. I believe that what God has done for me, he'll do for anybody. He's no respecter of persons. It has nothing to do with you being black, white, Japanese, Chinese, Korean, whatever. That's just an excuse. It has nothing to do with the fact that you don't have an education. It has nothing to do with the fact that you don't have the right house that you think you should have. It has nothing to do with anything. It has something to do with you. You have to look in the mirror and just tell yourself, the problem starts with me. Earlier, we aired the program. It's a mind thing, and they're going to re-air it once again. We had some technical difficulties, but we're going to re-air it again from 8 to 8:30. I want you to grab a hold to it. Remember, the programs are podcasts. That means that you can watch the program 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So anytime at your convenience, if you got a laptop, an iPad, if you got an iPhone, if you can access the computer, then you can access the program. And I don't want you just to do it for you. Now, remember, you want to be a blessing. Text people, email them, share share that information. Information is power. That's what's happening, is people will get information. They don't want to share it. But my thing is that I believe that God won't bring it to you if he can't get it through you. And so that's what I'm challenging people to do here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. There's some powerful, powerful men and women of God here in this area. And what God has called me to is those who are underprivileged, those who are low income, those who are struggling and challenging in life, those who are working jobs where they're making minimum wage. Listen, I know that you want to live better. I know that you don't love living your life and worry about how you're going to pay the rent and how you're going to make your car payment and how you're going to pay your cell phone bill. I mean, your whole life gets caught up in that cycle. It's like a rat on a treadmill running faster and faster and getting nowhere. Every time you get your check, it's already gone. And then you have the audacity to want to go out to a club and spend $15, $20 to get in, spend another $100 on drinks. Listen, if you begin to add up what you throw away, you can take what you throw away and use it to invest in. And that's where discipline comes in. You have to delay your gratification. We live in a society where people have what I call a microwave mentality. They want to be successful. They want to pop it in, press 1 minute, bang, it's ready. One thing Kevin Hart said, and he says so much, but only one thing he said that I got a hold to, he says, listen, everybody wants to be successful, but nobody wants to grind. That means that people are laying around waiting on somebody to come and do for them what they must do for themselves. We have a lot of sluggards and just flat out lazy bums. They rather just sit around and talk about what they're going to do, but they're not doing anything. I don't know how many people I've met tell me they're moving from Atlanta to New York. They're moving from New York to LA. And that was 3 years ago, because you can't just talk about it. There's a process to success. It doesn't happen overnight. An oak tree didn't become an oak tree overnight. It started out as a seed, and then it grew into an oak tree. And what I'm saying to you is you have to despise not small beginnings. If you research anyone that's successful today, from Tyler Perry to Steve Harvey and so many others, if you research them and take a look at their background, you'll find that these people came from the same places we came from. They came from the inner cities. They came from single-parent homes. They came from broken homes. They came from all type of situations and circumstances. You know, even in my new play that I'm doing, Born in Hell 2, it's a monologue. And I'm literally talking about everything that happened from the time I was born up until that day. And it's going to include my drug abuse. It's going to include my homelessness. It's going to include my molestation. It's going to talk about how I was homeless in my own hometown. Can you imagine being from Dallas and you don't have any place to live? And you're sleeping on the bridge, not by choice, but because your family won't even give you a place to live. Listen, people are ruthless. And so I thank and praise God for how he raised me up. He took the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. But I'm not running away. I'm not building a bigger house. I'm not putting a fortress around it. I'm not buying another Bentley. I'm not buying another Rolls. I'm not buying another Mercedes. I'm going to come back, and I'm going to make a difference in the community. I admire people like Emmitt Smith and Pat. You know, Pat has Treasure U, and Emmitt has his foundation. I mean, Troy Aikman. There's so many people here in the DFW area, specifically since this is where I'm going to be launching. There's people in this area that would literally help you. But listen, they'll help you if you're willing to help yourself. This is Paul Dunn. You're listening. Now's the time, and I'm challenging you today that you can break the stronghold that has you bound. You can break the drug addiction. I was bound by crack, as I said, and I didn't go to rehab. I didn't go through any type of programs. I literally prayed, and I trusted the Lord, and I asked the Lord, please, Lord, I need deliverance. And not only did he deliver me, but he took the taste out of my mouth. I've got a young man that's going to be coming onto the show within the next few weeks. That's his book right there. It's called The Champagne Life. Now, Kobe, I tell you, Kobe is just awesome. He started his own nightclub. I'm not talking about a hole in the wall, but his own nightclub. I think he started about $300,000 nightclub that he started out with. And now he's in L.A. He's a real mover and shaker. I was just out with him at a secret society dinner where we had some of the top CEOs from Warner Brothers and record labels and all these people. It was probably about 30, 40 people that came together and had a secret, what they call a secret society. And it's just such a blessing to learn the information, how people are making $100,000 a day. People are making $25,000 a day. When I share this type of information with people, some people can't even comprehend. And that's why even the show, some people can't even say million. But I want you to know that death and life are in the power of your tongue. As a man thinketh, so is he. If you don't think you can have a better car, you won't. If you don't think you can live in a better house, you won't. If you don't think you make more money than you're making now, you won't. If you don't ever think you can have your own business, you can't write a book, you can't do it. That's a self-prophecy. You're literally speaking that into existence. No one can stop you but you. Les Brown shares something with me. He says, listen, the only person that's limiting you is you. And so I'm challenging you today, all over the world, as you're listening, shoot me an email. which we're going back out on tour with the Purpose Plan Destiny Tour. We'll be coming to your city. It's about a 20-city tour. You can just give me a call at 214-504-3854 on Thursdays, live, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, or you can go anytime at your leisure, 24 hours a day and 7 days a week, and download the app. You can listen to the podcast. Listen, there are no excuses. Our excuses are unacceptable. If you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, I'm challenging you to come out. Be with us. Put it on your schedule. Don't say if I get time or if I can make it. Listen, we all make time for the things that are important to us. Barack Obama is the president of the United States, but I'm sure he makes time for his wife. He makes time for his children. He shows up at different events. Listen, because that which you give yourself to, that spirit will come live in you. And so if you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, I want to bring you into an environment of people who are way past paying their rent and way past worried about their mortgage, way past worried about a cell phone bill. You know, these people are in a position that they want to download the information to you. All you've got to do is come and receive. And I pray as you're listening today, I want you just to begin to think about, I'm ready to receive. And if you're ready to receive, I believe that God is ready to give it to you. He says, no good thing I withhold from those that walk upright before me. We're going to be talking and we're going to be sharing some things I believe will challenge you and also change your life. Once again, I want to thank my sponsors on today, Covenant Credit, that is located there at 405 North McDonald Street, Suite C in McKinney, Texas, 75069. You can reach them there at 972-529-6888. And when you call, they ask for Amanda Cash. What a name, Amanda Cash. Ask for her. If you'd like to visit their website, you can do that at mymoneytogo.com. That's Covington Credit. We give you credit for who you are. Also, Brother Jay at Jay's Barbershop. You can contact him at 469-288-8898. You can call for an appointment. You can just walk in. Remember, he has $7 Sundays for kids. He's located at 405 North McDonald Street, McKinney, Texas, 75069. Now, I know if you're in Arlington, Fort Worth, or some other place of that DeSoto, listen, that's a long ways to go to McKinney. But if you're in the McKinney area, then I'm challenging you to go to Jay's Bar. We've got to begin to support each other. I see this happening among the Italians, the Jews, the Indians, the Hispanics. Man, listen, there's one group that I'm affiliated with. They brought two people over here. They came from overseas, and two came and set up a household. Then two more came. Eventually, there was 10 people living in a one-bedroom house. But they all split up the rent. You know, they all split up all the expenses. And then after 3 months, they began to move out. But when they moved out, they had a nice bank account, and they were ready to really launch out and get on their own. What I'm saying to you, as a people, we've got to begin to support each other. It really irks me how we will pass by someone who can provide the services that we need and drive 10 or 15 miles to support something or to purchase something you can get right in your community. And so I'm challenging you out there as you're listening, specifically if you're in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. We're going to be doing some things here. We're actually working on what we're going to call the Night of Champions. And right now we're going to be we're trying to see if we can get Emmitt Smith, Deion Sanders, Jerry Jones, of course, you know, Ray Huffines, all these people to come together on one night. And then have us to come together and sit up under that type of success, that type of knowledge, that type of wisdom. Listen, everybody knows somebody. And it's all about connections. You know, we're going to be coming to Las Vegas. If you're listening, you're out in Las Vegas. I'll be in Las Vegas August 17th. Then we'll be there the 19th through the 21st for the Magic Show. We have about 80,000 people that attend that show. It's been going on for over 20 years. Every February and every August, I'm in Las Vegas. Tommy Hilfiger, Calvin Klein, Marcos Jabot, Sean P. Diddy Combs, Russell Simmons. Listen, anybody and everybody who's got a clothing line or, you know, Taylor Swift, or they got a company like cologne or whatever they may be doing, we come to that show twice a year. All the buyers from JCPenney's, Macy's, Dillard's, the clothing that you see in Stonebrow Mall and North Park Mall and Valley View, those are buyers who come out to Las Vegas and they purchase the clothing that you literally see in your local stores. Listen, if you're out there and you have a heart and you want to start a clothing line, we've got a gentleman that I just connected with who's a designer. Listen, God is really up to something, and I really want to be a part of the move of God. I want to experience the presence and the power of God. I truly believe it will bless your life. Now, let me challenge you with one last thing. When we talk about the Bible, it's one or two things. Either the Bible is all true or it's all a lie. Now, you've got to make a conscious decision which one you're going to believe. And I often tell people, I would rather live and die and find out it wasn't true than live to die and find out it was. Because there is no salvation beyond the grave. Maybe you're listening today and you said, listen, I am sick and tired of being sick and tired. I'm tired of being drunk. I'm tired of trying to get high. I'm tired of trying to see how many women I can sleep with. I'm tired of cheating on my wife. I'm tired of cheating. When you cheat on your wife, cheating on your children, I'm tired of it. I just want to change. I believe that change will restore what you accept in the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, this doesn't make you a religious freak or fanatic or anything. What it's going to do, it's going to bring you back into your right mind. That which was in place, taken out of place, and put back into its proper place. I believe that God wants to touch your life. If you're out there and you want to receive him, just say, listen, Jesus, forgive me of my sins. I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. Amen. It's just that simple. You don't have to go through no rituals. You ain't have to prove for nobody. I believe that God wants to visit you, and I won't believe that God wants to manifest what's in your life. Information with an application will bring a revelation, and a revelation will bring you manifestation. But if you get information and you don't know how to bring an application, it'll leave you in frustration. And there's a lot of frustrated people in the world today. That's why I often say, don't complain about that which you allow. We're going to play one last thing from the CD. It's something that God put in my heart. It's a moment of inspiration. And I think it's the very last one that's on that CD. And once again, you can go to Captown Records, INT.com, if you like. And you can hear some tidbits from each one of those songs. And I pray that you would not only listen to it, but you would purchase it. You can download it. It's available on Amazon. It's available on Google Play. It's available on just about every digital download there is. You can download that. Like I said, the singles are 99 cents. The MP3s, I believe, are $9.99. And I think if you want the actual CD, they'll mail that out. I think it's $12 or whatever the case may be. You can find out all that information if you just go to www.genesisgroup1.com. Don't be intimidated. I often tell people, you send me an email, I'll respond to you. I'll call you. We can chat. That's just how I am. I learned how to just be an everyday person. I believe that that's what God is raising up now, just everyday people who are willing to help somebody. So if there's anything I can do, just call me. It all starts with the information. We're going to go in. We're going to listen to a moment of inspiration. I'm going to come back and close the show, and I want to say thank you. God bless you for listening on today, and I'm certainly looking forward to speaking with you, and I pray that you get the chance to make it out on September 8th at 12 noon for the launching of the Champion Center Worldwide Outreach. God bless you.
Hi, this is Paul Dunn. Thanks for listening. I want to share five principles with you that I believe can change your life. Most people never finish because they never start. The first one is discipline. Discipline is delaying one's gratification. Then there's balance. Let the lesser things die, the greater may live. We must stop procrastinating. Procrastination is defined as waiting on a perfect time or condition to do that which you say you want to do. And then we have to operate in our now. Our now is defined as 2 to 5 seconds when God downloads a dream, vision, or an idea before it passes into our past memory files. And now we're going to apply what I call the repo principle. The R is repetitious, the E is easy, the P is pleasure, the O is often, and the H is habit. Whatever you do repetitiously will become easy. Whatever becomes easy will become a pleasure. Whatever becomes a pleasure, you'll be done often, and whatever you do often will become a habit. The Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. The Bible says in Romans 12:2, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Your whole life is built on your thoughts. The Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. And so your life become your thoughts. If you think you can't do no better than you're doing, you won't. If you think you can't drive a better car, you won't. If you don't think you can live in a better house, you won't. Your life is changed by your thoughts. If you change your thoughts, you'll change your life. Your behavior is based on your feelings, which are based upon your thoughts. Thoughts are everything. So the thing to work on is not to change your behavior, but those things inside of your conscience that we call thoughts. Once your thoughts reflect what you generally want to be, the appropriate emotions and the consequent behavior will flow automatically. You can't believe what you can't see. There are many steps in bringing forth your vision, your dream, or your idea. You must know how to manufacture, distribute, and advertise your product. Nothing can stop you from achieving your dreams except you. You are the worst enemy you have. It's the enemy in you. You have to leave where you are to get where you're going. Most people never, ever finish because they're constantly procrastinating and they never start. Here we are now in the year 2013, and there are people who talked about what they were going to do in 2012. They talked about what they were going to do in 2011. They talked about what they're going to do in 2010. And now, here we are 3 years later in 2013. I want to challenge you, America. If you keep doing what you're doing, you're going to keep getting what you got. If you want something different, you must do something different. You have to start somewhere. The Bible says, despise not small beginnings. I was sharing with a gentleman one day, and he was telling me that he wanted to start a t-shirt business. And I said, that's an awesome, awesome idea. He says, well, I'm going to go and I'm going to print up 1,000 t-shirts and I'm going to sell them all over. I said, listen to me. I said, if you can't sell 10 t-shirts, you can't sell 100. If you can't sell 100, you can't sell 1,000. What am I saying to you? What I'm saying to you is start with 10. Get you a marketing plan together to sell the 10 t-shirts. If you can sell 10, then you can sell 100. If you sell the 10, instead of eating the seed or eating the money or blowing the money, take the profits and reinvest it back into the company. Therefore, you have the money that you're putting back into it from your capital rather than constantly trying to raise capital. Before you know it, you'll be at 100 t-shirts. $10 times 100 is 1,000. You put the 1,000 back in and you sell another 100 shirts, then just the money just keeps adding up. But you can't get there unless you start somewhere. This is Paul Dunn, the American Motivator. Send visits at www.genesisgroup1.com. Remember, teamwork will make the dream work, and there's no I in team. Until we meet again, God bless.
God bless you, America. Once again, I want to thank PBJ Clothing. Get you some 5-Hour Energy, and of course, the Young Millionaires Association. Remember, our Stronghold CD is now available. You can pick that up by visiting GenesisGroup1.com. Once again, we want to invite you on September 8th to come out to the Champion Center. You can tweet me if you like at dundun58 or email me at dun58@msn.com. Remember, if you're not moving forward, you're moving backwards. This is Paul Dunn with Now's the Time, and God bless you. Listen, I'm going to be out of here. You stay there. We've got Andrea coming up next, and I know you're going to be blessed. Thank you so much, and we'll see you on next week right here on Deep In Media.
Deepinmedia.net.